हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। दिस इज द 14th लेक्चर फॉर क्लास 9 फिजिक्स रिलेटेड टू थर्ड चैप्टर ग्रेविटेशन। एंड इन दिस लेक्चर टुडे वी विल सॉल्व न्यूमेरिकल बेस्ड ऑन सम इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स। सो फर्स्ट न्यूमेरिकल दैट इज बेस्ड ऑन वेट फार्मूला कॉन्सेप्ट। लेट्स सी व्हाट इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ फार्मूला एंड हाउ टू सॉल्व द न्यूमेरिकल बेस्ड ऑन वेट कैलकुलेशन। वेरी इजी न्यूमेरिकल्स। Let's see question number 1. What is the weight of a kilogram mass, that is 1 kilogram, on earth, it means on our surface. So solution of this one, very easy. Here given terms, mass 1 kilogram and small g value also given, that is 9.8 meter per second square. The value of small g, that is 9.8 meter per second square given, and by formula w is equal to mg. W means what? That is weight. Weight is equal to mass into gravity. The value of mass, that is 1, and gravity value 9.8. So equal to what? 9.8 kg meter per second square, or we say that 9.8 newton. The weight of a body, or you say that object on earth, is equal to 9.8 newton. Very simple concept. When you just write one times, then everything will be clear. Only one simple formula, W is equal to mg, and put in the value and solve out. Just note down, after this we will solve second. In second numericals, we have to discuss about the gravitational force. How the gravitational force vary whenever the distance first becomes doubled and second, that is halved. Just listen, what is the concept of question? What happens to the gravitational force between two objects when the distance between them is number 1 doubled and number 2 halved? Solution of this one, very easy concept. First, we are knowing what? Gravitational force by Newton's law. F is equal to G M1 M2 upon R square. This is the formula for force by Newton's law. And make this one equation number 1. First condition, whenever this distance, this is the distance between two objects, suppose here object having mass m1 and here object having mass m2, distance between their center, that is r. Whenever the distance becomes doubled, then force between them, we have to calculate what? Whenever the distance between them is doubled, is it m1 and m2 separated by finite distance r, then the force is F is equal to g m1 m2 upon r square. And when the distance between the objects, it becomes what? Double. This is M1, and suppose the object, whenever the distance becomes double, so this is M1 and this one is M2. Any distance becomes what? 2R. then the force will be least, because the force is inversely proportional to distance. You see, when R dash is equal to 2R, or we say that R1 is equal to 2R, then the concept of force F1 is equal to G M1 M2 upon R1 square, but the value of R1 what? 2R. So capital G M1 M2 upon 2R square. Then this one becomes what? Capital G M1 M2 upon 4R square. So 1 upon 4 capital G M1 M2 upon R square. This capital G M1 M2 upon R square means what? That is from first F. So F1 is equal to 1 upon 4 F. It means the force becomes what? 1 upon 4 times. 1 upon 4 times the initial value of force. F1 is equal to 1 upon 4 F. Clear? It means force becomes 1 fourth of the initial value of force. Second condition, whenever the distance becomes what? R. Then what will be the force? Very simple concept. You see, after this, just note down all. In second condition, just reverse of the initial condition. By Newton's law, the formula is same. Initial F is equal to what? G M1 M2 upon R square. And initially here two objects M1 and M2. M1 and M2 separated by distance R. Separated by distance R. Whenever the distance becomes what? Halved. M1 and M2. Just reverse case. And this one distance becomes what? That is R by 2. Half means what? 1 upon 2. Here initial value R and final value R upon 2. Then we have to find out what? The force. When R2 is equal to what? R by 2. R2 is equal to R by 2. Then F2 is equal to? F2 is equal to G M1 M2 upon R2 square. R2 square. The value of R2, that is R by 2. So F2 is equal to capital G M1 M2 upon R by 2 square. Then this 2 square becomes 4, but multiplied in numerator side. So 4 G M1 M2 upon R square. And here G M1 M2 upon R square, that means from first, that is equal to F. So F2 is equal to 4 F. It means force becomes what? 4 times. Very simple concept. Whenever the distance becomes double, then force becomes 1 upon 4 times, and whenever the distance becomes halved, then the force becomes 4 times. Inversely proportional here, just opposite concept. Whenever one increases, then other decreases. Whenever other increases, then one decreases. So simple concept, just note down. After this, we will solve third numerical. Just see, the third numerical, that is very easy and very interesting. That is based on your previous concept. Previous concept, it means from first chapter, that is motion. In motion chapter, we will discuss three equations of motion. Three equations of motion. First equation, second equation and third equation. So all the three equations are very important. here in this numerical we will use the concept of equations of motion but under the influence of gravity. It means whenever a body dropped from certain height towards ground level, then the acceleration used at ascent due to gravity, and whenever thrown up, then acceleration used in the terms of gravity with negative sign. Then see, for the concept, a cricket ball is dropped and it dropped from a height. It means u is equal to 0. Whenever dropped from a height, then the concept, first u is equal to 0 from a height of 20 meter. It means h is equal to 20 meter, and we have to calculate what? First calculate the speed of the ball. It means we have to calculate v, and what is given also, small g given here, that is 10 meter per second square. G is equal to 10 meter per second square. This is the solution of first concept. So in u v, this is g is using at the place of a, and here h means height, at the place of distance, yes. So second equation not applicable because time is not given here. So we use what? Third concept of a formula, that is by third equation of motion, v square is equal to u square plus 2gh. U 0, so v square is equal to 2 into 10 into 20 is equal to what? 400. V square is equal to 400. It means v is equal to square root of 400, that is 20 meter per second. Very easy. Whenever the formula concept is clear, then you can solve out within few minutes easily. And second solution of B, calculate the time it takes to fall through this height. It means we have to calculate what? Time. And for time we use what? By first equation of motion, v is equal to u plus gt. As I explained earlier, whenever body just falling downward, then acceleration only replacing by small g, that is ascent due to gravity. So u here 0 plus g means that is 10, and time we have to find out, and v final velocity just calculated what? 20. So t is equal to 20 upon 10, that is equal to 2 seconds. So E solution, when you just clear your formula concept, then you can solve out easily. So after this numerical solving, in next lecture we will solve out some more numerical based on few different topics that is taught earlier in this chapter. So you will just revise some numericals that is given in your NCERT book or other inside book, no matter. You can solve any one numericals from any one book. If any confusion, then you can ask. So you will just practice out. If any confusion, then you can ask. So thank you so much for this, and have a nice day.